So by now, it should be evident to pretty much everyone that Howard Schultz is a complete and utter joke, because not only does he lack a political agenda, he doesn't know anything about the policy specifics, and he demonstrated this during the CNN town hall. Because he was trying to scold us about the cost of Medicare for All, saying it would cost $32 trillion, for example, when the total cost of our current healthcare system is almost $60 trillion, and Medicare for All would actually save us $2 trillion. Now that's a more conservative estimate. In actuality, it would save us anywhere between 5 and 15 trillion. But to say, oh, Medicare for All costs 32 trillion, he's demonstrating that he doesn't know what he's talking about. No, our current system costs $60 trillion. The 32 trillion number that you're citing, all that refers to is the increase in federal spending, because obviously, if you switch to a single-payer system, you increase federal spending, but state and local spending goes down simultaneously. So, if you're going to talk numbers, then at least try to know what you're talking about. At least read the studies that you're going to cite. So, I wish that that host at the CNN town hall, Poppy Harlow, would have just asked him, hey, Howard, how much does our current system cost? Because it would expose him as someone who is ignorant and who's a political fraud. But the point is that Howard Schultz is a joke, and he's basically a whiny billionaire who's only considering running because he doesn't want the Democratic Party to nominate a candidate who is a progressive who would actually raise his taxes. So Howard Schultz isn't even a serious contender. Rather, he's a spoiler candidate whose entire campaign is based on a threat to hand Donald Trump a second term if he doesn't get his way. So his goal here is to bully the entire left, ranging from, you know, the left to the center left, bully the entire left into nominating a centrist. Because he's made it very clear, he's actually admitting now, if you nominate someone like Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, or even Kamala Harris, I'm gonna run. And I'm going to hand this election to Donald Trump. He's not saying that he's going to hand the election to Donald Trump, but he is saying, if you do what I say, then I won't run. And make no mistake about it, that's a threat. And that's detailed in a Washington Post article where he basically says, look, if you want to get rid of me, then you can't nominate a progressive. And as Michael Shearer and Tracy Jan of the Washington Post report, former Starbucks CEO Howard Schultz said Thursday that he would be willing to abandon his presidential ambitions midstream if Democrats nominate a centrist who makes it too difficult for him to win as an independent candidate. Schultz, who made the comments while visiting the Washington Post, has premised his exploration of a presidential campaign on the assumption that Democrats are likely to nominate a candidate that embraces what he calls far-left ideas that will turn off enough moderate voters to open space for an independent candidate. He has paid for internal polling that he says suggests he would be competitive in a three-way race against President Trump and a liberal Democratic candidate such as Senator Kamala Harris, Elizabeth Warren, or Senator Bernie Sanders, a more moderate Democratic nominee such as former Vice President Joe Biden or former New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg, could complicate Schultz's perceived path to victory. I would reassess the situation if the numbers change as a result of a centrist Democrat winning the nomination, Schultz said. Those comments could influence the internal Democratic debate over the best nominee to take on Trump, giving moderates an opportunity to argue that their nomination would minimize the threat of a Schultz bid. So, reading this made me so angry. I cannot even tell you. I was tweeting about this on Friday. I was so pissed off. Because who the fuck do you think you are? Like, the gall of this guy. Nominate who I want. Someone who's not going to raise my taxes. Otherwise, I'm going to jump in the race specifically to spoil it so Donald Trump gets a second term. And I love how he's trying to say that what he's doing is pragmatic and how Democrats would be, you know, it would behoove them to run a centrist, but we just tried this. If you'll recall, Howard, I don't know what you were doing, but we were all watching Hillary Clinton faceplant, and she ultimately lost to Donald Trump. So this isn't up for debate. This isn't hypothetical. We saw what happened when Democrats nominated a centrist. They lost, and a reality television show star became the president. So what the fuck are you talking about? That enough moderate voters will be turned off? Republicans nominated a far-right extremist, and Democrats did exactly what you wanted them to do. They nominated a centrist, actually someone who is center-right, and they lost. So what do you have to say about that, Howard? They nominated someone that was theoretically appealing to moderate voters, and what happened? Their base stood home. So this guy doesn't know what he's talking about, and whatever internal polling shows that he would do well in a three-way race against, you know, Bernie Sanders and Donald Trump, that's nonsense. You have a 4% approval rating, dipshit. Nobody likes you and nobody takes you seriously, and you're not even running on a real agenda. He's not saying, I'm running because I support this incrementalist approach to education or taxes. You don't even have policy specifics at the CNN town hall. Again, you couldn't even say what your proposals were, only that you don't like Trump's proposals and the Republican Party's proposals, and you don't like the left's proposals. So you have no real ideas. You have no real core base, and yet you think we're going to believe that you're going to be the person to step in and save the day when we all know you're only jumping in the race, or you only would jump in the race to be a spoiler to give Donald Trump a second term, because even if you don't like Donald Trump, you at least know that your taxes won't go up, whereas with Bernie Sanders or Elizabeth Warren, your taxes would go up. So understand that people who are currently butting heads right now, the Bernie supporters and the Kamala supporters, understand we all have a mutual interest here in taking on Howard Schultz, because he threatens whoever wins, be it Kamala Harris or Bernie Sanders. If one of them win, then Howard Schultz is threatening to give Donald Trump a second term. So we need to view him as a common enemy, and we need to respond accordingly. And what I think we need to do is organize a boycott. And I'm not talking about individuals who are saying, oh, well, I stopped, you know, drinking Starbucks coffee years ago. I'm talking about a real boycott, a grassroots level boycott where we have picket signs at every fucking Starbucks. Because if Howard Schultz wants to basically threaten us and say he's going to step in and spoil the election if we nominate someone who he doesn't agree with, then we can play ball too. We can play his game. We can play dirty, and we'll just boycott Starbucks. And stage a real boycott, not, you know, a conservative boycott where they burn their Nikes or they all just personally commit to not shopping there. An actual boycott where you lose money, Howard, because I believe he still holds a majority shares in the company. So that would personally affect his wallet. And that's what you've got to do. You've got to hit him where it hurts, and that's their wallet. So I was so angry, so angry. How dare you threaten to subvert democracy? You don't even have any real ideas. You're just running to spoil it. What a despicable person you are.
Mike is a total loser, so don't hit the subscribe button, okay? And whatever you do, folks, do not hit the notification bell either. Mike treats me so unfairly.